Welcome everyone. Now we are going to see how to perform molecular docking using AutoDock tools. So this is the protein file and this is the ligand file. We are going to do docking using the AutoDock. First step is the protein preparation. So this is the protein file. We are going to prepare this protein file. For protein preparation, we are going to use the Molygro molecular viewer. Open this Molygro molecular viewer tool. And import the protein file. So go to file and import molecules. Import this protein file. While importing, uncheck these waters and ligands. We don't need the water and ligands. We need only the protein. This protein has only a chain. So we are going to import this. Now the protein is imported successfully in this workspace. This protein does not have water molecules and ligands and any other cofactors. So we are going to export the molecule. While exporting, we are going to export only the protein entry. So select the format as protein data bank and give the file name. I'm going to save. Now the protein is saved. This protein molecule does not have water and ligand. This file contains only the amino acid residues. So we are going to use this in the AutoDock tools. Before that, we have to energy minimize the ligand molecules. So this is the ligand chalcone. We have to energy minimize the ligand. For that, we are going to use the Chem3D. Using Chem3D, we are going to do the energy minimization for the ligand. Now I am opening the Chem3D. After opening Chem3D, I am going to import the ligand file here. So this is the ligand file. This is in the 2D format. I am going to do the energy minimization step. For that, I am going to use the MM2 force field. So click on this and the energy minimization will happen. So the energy minimization is completed and the result is shown here. After doing the energy minimization, save the ligand as PDB format or MOL2 format. I am going to save it as PDB format in the same folder. Now we have successfully completed the energy minimization step. Now we are going to open the AutoDock tools. Okay, this is the AutoDock tools. So first of all, you all know how to set the preferences. Go to file preferences and set the startup directory. That's all. Now we are going to read molecule file and click on this protein file. This protein file has only the amino acid residues. It does not have the ligand or any other cofactors or water molecules. It have only the amino acid residues. So I am going to open this. The file is imported now. Next we are going to edit. And we are not going to delete the water because we have already removed water in the previous step. Next we are going to add the hydrogens. Add. And polar only. So after adding the hydrogens, we are going to merge the non-polar hydrogens. The non-polar hydrogens are merged. Next, we are going to check for missing atoms. Here, zero residues with the missing atoms, so we don't need to worry. Next, we are going to add the Coleman charges for the protein. Coleman charges are added. Next, we are going to edit and atoms, and we are going to assign the AD4 type. Now the protein preparation is completed. Next, we are going to go for the ligand preparation. Go to the ligand and input and open the ligand. The ligand is in the PDB format. Open this chalcone. Now the gastric charges are added and nonpolar hydrogens are merged, and it found 12 aromatic carbons and it detected the rotatable bonds and set the torsions. Next, we are going to save this ligand as the PDBQT format in the same folder. After that, we are going to create the grid file. Go to the grid and the macromolecule and choose. Now we are going to choose the macromolecule and not the open. The macromolecule is already present here, so we are going to choose. This is the macromolecule, this is the ligand file. I am going to choose the macromolecule. Now we are going to save this macromolecule as the PDBQT format. Okay. After saving, the color will change like this. Now we are going to set the map types. Go to grid and set map types. And we are going to choose the ligand. The ligand is already present here, so we are not going to open. We are going to choose. So this is the ligand. We are going to choose this ligand. This is the macromolecule, this is the ligand. We are choosing this ligand and select ligand. Next, we are going to set the grid box. Go to the grid and set grid box. Adjust these parameters to cover this entire macromolecule. Or if you know the active site, you can set the grid box for only the active site. Before that, we are going to change this spacing. I am going to set the spacing as 1 angstrom. Now the grid is covering the macromolecule in all directions. So go to file and close saving the current. Next, go to grid and output and save as GPF. This is the grid parameter file. We are going to save this as GPF. And in the same folder, we are going to name it as grid.gpf. Now we are going to set the docking parameters. Go to the docking and macromolecule and set rigid file name. Here we are going to choose the macromolecule. This is the macromolecule, this is the ligand. So we are going to choose the macromolecule. Next, go to docking and ligand. We are going to choose, because it is already present here. Go to ligand and choose. This is the ligand file and this is the macromolecule. We are going to choose the ligand. Select ligand. Click here, select ligand. And these are the ligand atom types and the center of the ligand molecule, and some other options are here, and you can accept the changes. Next, go to ligand and search parameters, set as genetic algorithm. Here you can change some parameters. Here you can, if you want, You can change the number of genetic algorithm runs, or you can change the population size, or number of evaluations, short, medium, or long. Or you can edit the number of generations and rate of crossover, etc. Or if you don't want to change anything, just click on accept. Next, go to docking and docking parameters. Here, if you want to change anything, click here and you can change this. But we are going to use the defaults for all the options. Next, go to docking and output. Lamarckian genetic algorithm. Now we are going to save this as DPF format. After saving the DPF format, the folder will contain the doc.dpf file and the previous file also, grid.gpf, along with other files, protein PDBQT file and ligand PDBQT file. Next, we are going to generate the grid files. For that, next we are going to run and run autogrid. This is the first step. Next, run autodoc. This is the second step. First, we are going to run the autogrid. On the parameter file name, click on browse and choose the GPF file. This is the grid parameter file. To run the autogrid, we have to choose the grid parameter file, GPF file, and open. After that, the log file and the command will autocomplete. Now we have to click on launch. Before launching, we are going to see the command window. This command window is already running along with the Autodoc tools. We are not opening a new command window. If we encounter any error while running this autogrid, the error will be displayed in this command window. Now we are ready to launch. So, launching. After launching, you will have this small process window. You will have the small process manager. This is the Autodoc process manager. While running, after completion of this process, this window will automatically disappear. If you encounter any error, the error will be displayed in the command prompt that is already present here. Okay. After completion of this autogrid program, it will disappear automatically. So we have to wait some time. Now the autogrid program is completed. We are going to see if there are any errors. We do not have any errors. If we have any errors, it will be displayed here. Errors or warnings. Next, we are going to run the autodoc. On the similar way, we are going to choose this parameter files. The parameter file is the DPF file. This is the doc.dpf file. This is the docking parameter file. After opening this, log file name and command will be auto-completed. Now we are ready to launch this. After launching, if we have any errors, it will also be displayed in this command window. Note that we are not opening any new command window or entering this command. We are simply launching this program. Now the Autodoc process manager will appear. After completion of docking process, this small window will disappear automatically. In the meantime, if you have any errors, it will also be displayed in this command window. In the same command window. Okay. So we have to wait until this process is completed. In the meantime, we are going to check this folder. In this folder, we have several files now. Here we have the grid files, that is map files and FLD file and XYZ file, along with the grid log file and docking log file. This log file is generated while we are running the autogrid program. This file will be generated while we are running the autodoc program. Now the autodoc program is running. Also, this is the result file. We can open this result file and we can check our results. Now the process is completed. we are going to check whether we get any errors. So we do not get any errors. So we are going to check this folder also. We successfully generated the doc.dlg file. After successful completion, we get this doc.dlg file. We can open this and we can see the result. It took the 7 minutes 45 seconds. Next, we are going to analyze the results. For that, go to Analyze, Dockings, and Open. We are going to open the docking log file, doc.dlg file. After opening, it will show the read 10 docked confirmations from doc.dlg. Use Analyze, Confirmations, and Play. Okay. Next, we are going to Macromolecule, Analyze Macromolecule, and now we are going to click on Open. It will automatically open the macromolecule here. Next, we are going to Confirmation and Play Ranked by Energy. This time, the player will show here. We can hide first two entries. Click on this one to center this. And you can play one by one this one, and click on this one and click show info. The binding energy is -4.84, next is -3.81, and so on. These are the 10 confirmations we got. Among them, highest one is the first confirmation, -4.84. So go to Analyze, Dockings, and Show Interactions. You can click on this Display MSMS and uncheck this option. So this is the ligand and this is the hydrogen bond interaction. These are the nearby residues. Now the hydrogen bond is formed between the ligand and leucine 141. That's all. You can save image by clicking here. Now the docking is completed. We are going to save the output file. So keep it in the first confirmation and you have to click on the build current. After this, click on the write complex and save it as the PDBQT format. This file will contain the macromolecule along with the docked ligand in this specific pose. Okay. Now the docking is completed and we have saved the result.pdbqt file. You can further analyze the result.pdbqt file with the PyMol or any other tool. And you can also get the 2D interactions and 3D interactions using the PyMol. That's all. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.